Pseudofolliculitis barbae, PFB, is a skin condition that results from shaving or other hair removal methods that cause ingrown hairs and inflammation in the beard area. It is a common problem in people with curly hair and is characterized by small, painful bumps or pimples that may become infected and result in scarring. Pseudofolliculitis barbae is also known as razor bumps or barber's itch. In this video, we will introduce the pseudofolliculitis barbae overview, causes, symptoms, diagnosis, complication, treatment options and home remedies. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. Signs and symptoms of pseudofolliculitis barbae. The signs and symptoms of pseudofolliculitis barbae include small, red or dark bumps on the skin. Itching and or tenderness in the affected area. Inflammation of the skin, redness and swelling. Hyperpigmentation, dark spots. Formation of pustules, pus-filled bumps. Scarring. These symptoms are usually most pronounced in the beard area, but can also occur on other areas of the body where hair is shaved or removed. Pseudofolliculitis barbae causes. Pseudofolliculitis barbae, also known as razor bumps, is caused by hair that has been cut or shaved at an angle, which can cause the hair to curl back and grow into the skin instead of out of the follicle. This is more likely to occur in individuals with curly hair. Other factors that can contribute to the development of pseudofolliculitis barbae include shaving too closely or frequently, using dull razors or other hair removal tools, ingrown hairs, oily skin, skin irritation, tight clothing or headwear that rubs against the skin. Pseudofolliculitis barbae can also be more common in individuals with darker skin tones, as the increased melanin in the skin can lead to more severe inflammation and hyperpigmentation. How is pseudofolliculitis barbae diagnosed? Pseudofolliculitis barbae can usually be diagnosed based on its characteristic appearance and symptoms. A dermatologist or other healthcare provider may perform a physical examination of the affected area and ask about the patient's medical history, including any previous skin conditions or hair removal practices. In some cases, a skin biopsy may be performed to rule out other possible causes of the symptoms. The healthcare provider may also ask the patient about their hair removal practices, and may recommend modifications to the patient's routine to reduce the risk of further irritation or ingrown hairs. If there is concern that the condition may be infected or complicated, the healthcare provider may recommend further tests or refer the patient to a specialist for further evaluation. What are the complications of pseudofolliculitis barbae? Pseudofolliculitis barbae can lead to several complications, particularly if left untreated or if the affected area becomes infected. These can include scarring. Repeated irritation and inflammation of the skin can cause scarring, particularly in more severe cases. Infection. Bacteria can enter the affected hair follicles and cause an infection, which can result in painful, red, and swollen bumps. In severe cases, an abscess may form. Hyperpigmentation. Dark spots or patches of skin may develop at the site of the bumps, particularly in individuals with darker skin tones. Keloids. Keloids are raised, thick, and sometimes itchy scars that can develop at the site of an injury or inflammation. Some individuals with pseudofolliculitis barbae may be at higher risk for developing keloids. Psychosocial effects. Razor bumps can be unsightly and may lead to embarrassment or low self-esteem, particularly if they occur on the face. It is important to seek treatment for pseudofolliculitis barbae to prevent complications and improve the appearance of the affected area. Treatment options of pseudofolliculitis barbae. Treatment options for pseudofolliculitis barbae include shaving modifications. This involves changing the way you shave to reduce the risk of razor bumps. This may include using a single-bladed razor, avoiding close shaves, and shaving in the direction of hair growth. Topical treatments. Topical treatments such as corticosteroids, retinoids, or antibiotics may be prescribed to reduce inflammation and prevent infection. Chemical depilatories. These are products that use chemicals to dissolve hair at the surface of the skin, reducing the risk of ingrown hairs. Laser hair removal. This is a medical procedure that uses laser energy to destroy hair follicles, preventing hair growth and reducing the risk of razor bumps. Electrolysis. This is a procedure that uses electric currents to destroy hair follicles, preventing hair growth and reducing the risk of razor bumps. Excision of affected hair follicles. This may be recommended in severe cases where other treatments have been ineffective. It is important to work with a healthcare provider or dermatologist to determine the most appropriate treatment option for your individual case. In some cases, a combination of treatments may be recommended for optimal results. Pseudofolliculitis barbae home remedies. There are several home remedies that may help reduce the symptoms of pseudofolliculitis barbae, although they may not be as effective as medical treatments. These remedies include: warm compresses. Applying a warm compress to the affected area can help reduce inflammation and soothe the skin. Aloe vera. Aloe vera has anti-inflammatory properties and can help reduce skin irritation. Apply aloe vera gel to the affected area and leave on for 10 to 15 minutes before rinsing off. Tea tree oil. Tea tree oil has antimicrobial and anti-inflammatory properties and can help reduce the risk of infection. Apply a small amount of tea tree oil to the affected area using a cotton ball. Witch hazel. Witch hazel has astringent properties and can help reduce inflammation and soothe the skin. Apply witch hazel to the affected area using a cotton ball. Exfoliation. Regular exfoliation can help prevent ingrown hairs by removing dead skin cells that can clog hair follicles. Use a gentle exfoliating scrub or brush to exfoliate the affected area. It is important to note that home remedies may not be effective for all cases of pseudofolliculitis barbae, and it is important to seek medical treatment if symptoms persist or worsen. Additionally, some home remedies may cause skin irritation or allergic reactions in some individuals, so it is important to patch test before applying to a larger area. Thanks for watching. Take care and stay safe.